understand what she was referring to. Like I said, she's married at the time. Okay? So, a feast came up. Me and my wife were getting into it because we found out this lady that I was talking to was getting a divorce from her husband. Okay? I didn't know this. I had no idea until they told us. Okay, so they were going over stuff. Well, this lady in Dow was going up to the tabernacle and having meetings. Well, they were bringing my wife. Well, something just in my spirit was getting like fed up over it after time. And I'm like, this don't feel right. Something just don't feel right to me. And I told her, I don't want you a part of that no more. That's not our business. I want you to stay out of it. So that's not what happened. I don't know how much it happened that I know of, but I know it happened a few times. She started talking to Dow, my wife, behind my back. I don't know if Dow influenced this or what. What was going on was they were convincing my wife that I wanted this lady because I asked her that question that day in the pavilion. Mind you, I asked four other women the same question. Four. And this lady's married. So was I. I wanted her? What? Huh? She's a married woman. How could I want that woman? She's already taken by another man. That makes no sense to me or the whole situation. So, mind you, no one ever came to me over this. Ever. One time. Never. So, there was a feast day going on, and me and my wife got into it, and we were supposed to be in the tents. My wife left. She was gone for a while. So I went back to the trailer to see if she was there. Mm-mm. So I sat there and waited and waited and waited and waited for a while. All of a sudden, she shows up with Dow, just her and Dow. I was confused, like, what the hell? This is like 11, 12 at night? Yeah. And he just didn't really say, he goes, oh, I'm just going to go to bed. Because he could tell I was a little upset. Like, what the hell is going on here? Like, so the next morning, so actually me and my lady, or me and my wife, we started getting in an argument that night over, you know, that and like, what's going on? Like, you know, so the lady that she was involved with it, you know, and I did say, I go, I hate that lady. Cause she was like in our business. She was like, kind of like feeding my wife shit in her ear, tweet, 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 you know, the Tweety Bird crap. And that's what was going on. And Dow was doing the same thing. I don't know for sure. So I can't say that it's hearsay out of my mouth. So, but that's what he was doing because there's other evidence I will tell you. And I know this is my side of the story, but there's other evidence that he was talking to my wife behind my back. I already told you one. So the next morning he calls me out in front of his house and I'm right up next door. I'm supposed to be sleeping in the tent, but I wasn't because we got into it and blah, blah, blah. Our tent got flooded. Anyways, whatever. So he called me out there and he apologized to me for talking to my wife without my knowledge. He said he thought I knew. How would I know that? That late at hour? 10, 11 o'clock at night, I know you're with my wife? How in the hell would I know that? I had no clue. Not one clue. I didn't know what to believe. 11 o'clock at night, I know you're with my wife. How in the hell would I know that? I had no clue. Not one clue.
11 o'clock at night, I know you're with my wife. How in the hell would I know that? I had no clue. Not one clue.
Someone to hold you tight. All the praises go to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Recha HaKodesh, and double honors to the other apostles and bishops of Great Millstone. Salute and honors to all you other brethren, you fellow believers in support of this ministry, the ones of you support this ministry. That includes you sisters as well. And shalom to the elect. So, anyway, I want to go back on another edition of this man, Pastor Dial. I actually saw this clip yesterday. This man uploaded his channel. It's called Zay or something. It was one channel. I guess he just went to YouTube to upload this one particular video on his page and give his testimony. So I'm going to give a response to this testimony. But first, before I get started, I'm not sure if this is the particular woman that's in the video. I know this woman was caught up as an adulteress from someone else. So I don't, you know, it's so much going on. I just put this woman back in here because this was the previous video of the same situation happening. Now, first, one thing I noticed about this man here, it could be a Jake, but the one thing I noticed about this man here, he's too nice, right? He's too soft. He's too nice. And he's too easygoing. And these predators, like Pastor Dial, who grew up in a militia, he knows the psychological, he understands psychological warfare. And he knows exactly what to do and how to do it, to manipulate, to twist and turn and pull. And, you know, the scriptures talk about the lust of, woe to you of your father, that ye are your father's the devil, and the lust of your father ye will, let me get this, John 8:44, and then I'll get further into this, understand, going into this lesson. Ye are your father's the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. As another scripture says, with Yahawashah quoted, when someone says, here is the Messiah, believe him not. Don't go running to these guys. You know, this man is sick. He's got all these fetishes, this cuckold fetish, which that word goes into a man that takes pleasure in stealing other men's wives. So he has that manipulation of that war militia spirit, or military militia type of spirit. This man is sick, right? He's a sick man. Now, another thing I'll say to this guy, you know, let me see if I can look up this word. He says, I got a great heart. You know, it's almost like that Christian mentality, you know, that white Christian mentality, where you're willing to go above and beyond, which you should for your brother. I'm not saying you shouldn't, but you got to have a perspective on that. Ecclesiastes 7:16. It says in the God's Word translations, don't be too virtuous, right? And don't be too wise. Why make yourself miserable? Now, the other translation is, be not righteous over much. Now, this man had built the foundation of the Straightway Ministries. He's a carpenter, and he was probably really sincere in what he's done. But you see what happened. Let's go to Proverbs 4:23. This is what it says. This is what the scripture says. It says, keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Now, I'm going to read it in the NLT. Guard your heart above all things, for it is determined the course of your life. See, they see these things, these predators. They zoom in and they see it, especially if you got a wife. And as I said before in the last video, a lot of these women that are in these ministries or in those situations of that compound or whatever, that Rambo setup that he got set up, those women see this man as powerful. They see this man as a protector. In the other video I put up yesterday, this woman actually said that. She said, I feel safe. I feel protected. This man is an actual king in his kingdom, you know? And it was made to be that way. And this is what happens when you become righteous over much, in even in yourself. Pride has puffed him up and lifted him up. And now he's thinking he's on the level of Yahawashah. Well, he don't even believe in the Messiah, I don't think. Anyway, it says, guard your heart more than anything else. This is what the other translation says, which is your spirit, man. You got to guard it, man. You just can't. But this man was too trusting. He went there and he took his wife. You know, his wife saw the leader and she wanted to leave him and jump up to the top. I'd imagine these are incidents that we're seeing now, right, that are coming out. Can you imagine how much more this has been going on in all those years? This man is a serial adulterer. He's a sick serial adulterer, man. Let's look up this word nice. You'd be surprised what this word says for some of you who don't know. The word nice actually means foolish and ignorant. Frivolous, right? Frivolous, which means of little weight or importance. That's what happened. You know, Dow, you know, stood up and quoted himself a king, a master of the compound. See, he's like that Rambo, man. You know, that militia stuff where he's out and he made his own setup, you know, his own so-called war zone or militia zone, right? But he did it in the name of the Lord. You know, they did it in the name of understanding truth in the Bible. This is what makes this man so sick, right? And then now he managed to take this compound or this big gateway or straightway thing he got, and now he's managed to heap to himself wives. And then he was talking about, when I was listening to it, he was talking about how he would pass other women around, right, that were already married. And maybe it's because of his sick fetish that he wanted to pass women to other women so he can get involved and sleep with them. This man probably had threesomes, and I can't quote that and say that's true. But if this man, mine, it's probably sicker than we thought, man. Anyway, this word foolish goes back to senseless, foolish, careless, and clumsy. This is what happened, man, when you're too nice, weak, and poor, needy, simple, stupid, silly, and foolish. Yeah, I wish I wasn't like that. All super nice and goofy. You know what I'm saying? You trusted this man with your wife. And then what this woman did, let me get into that. Then what this woman did, she already knew what was up. You got to understand, these women, this man doesn't understand women. He doesn't understand power. And this woman was already checking Pastor Dial out, man. It had to be. And this woman got in an argument with Pastor King Dial, with her husband, for a reason. If a woman is arguing with you all day, all night, she don't want to be around you, it's because somewhere else she wants to be. So she created an argument, got herself mad, and then zipped out of there to be with Dial. Now, I wonder what the Dialman, right, was doing for all that time she was gone. And then this man, Pastor Dow, had the nerve to step back up and come to him and apologize, I guess, like nothing happened, and said he thought he knew. That's why I call him the cuckold prophet, man. That's what he does. He gets off of messing with other men's wives, right? That's what this man does. So let's go on to 2 Timothy 3 and 5. I don't think I'll make this long, 3 and 6. For this sort are they which creep into houses or tents and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with diverse lust. This man is nothing more than a mature nature boy, right? Because he's using the Bible. So, you know, he kind of have some more wits with him because of the scriptures. But he's nothing more than a grown nature boy, an old nature boy. That's all he is, man. So how did he creep in the house and take captive silly women? The power. You know, all it takes is that power. Once you have that power, you have everything. This is the same thing. You brothers, and some of you who don't know this, when you take your women around certain people, and these women will tell you, oh, you're just insecure. You're just insecure because you're afraid of someone, other man, taking your woman, right? And that should always be the case. And there's nothing wrong with being insecure because nothing is secure here. Nahum 3:1 says, woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. The prey departeth not. As this man can see, and the other man can see, if he took the hand and said, like everybody else say, oh, you're just insecure. You know what that says? That terminology of being insecure is given the license of the woman to go do as she will. The scripture says to keep eye over, you know, over your eve, your rib. Right? A lot I can't say in here. But you got to keep watch. And then you got to show yourself. If you're in that situation, you got to show yourself authoritative. This Pastor Dow probably chewed him out, was telling him what to do. And this is why that word nice shows to be foolish and simple and weak. It actually says weak. That's stupid. So Pastor Dow is sitting there in the king's seat with his throne, right? And he's telling her this man what to do and controlling the whole situation. And his wife is sitting there looking at this. Now, we're talking about 2024. We ain't talking about women of the ancient times that kind of understood that. Now, we're talking about women today. The Eves today, the women today, they understand power and that's what they want. So you got to hide your woman from around... You got to hide your wives, man. Proverbs 3:20. You know, the scripture says, give not wicked woman liberty to gad abroad, right? Give the water no patches. You know what happens when a dam breaks? Do you know what will happen if your water leaks from your second floor to the basement? You have no idea where that water went. It then went into every crack or crevice that you can imagine. That's why it says, give the water no passage. Once you let the water out, you don't know what happened. Now, my assumption would be if this man, wife picked an argument with him just to be with Pastor Dow for some hours, my assumption would be, yeah, they was committing adultery. And let's say they didn't actually physically do it. That adultery starts in the heart, man. You didn't already did it. You didn't already, you know, disrespected this man. This woman that disrespected her husband, and they all supposed to be people of the Bible. This goes to show you just because somebody has the Bible, don't make them righteous, right? Doesn't make them righteous. Let's keep reading that. Proverbs 30:20, it says, such the way of an adulterous woman, she eateth and wipeth her mouth and saith, I have done no wickedness. Now, I can only hope that this man that went through this situation, he done moved on, and this wife of his was deemed unworthy and untrustworthy. Because if a man did it, you know, it'd be far, far worse in this society, right? But she picked an argument with him, stepped out, and was gone for hours. Now, that wasn't the first time she did that. From what this man told me in the story, she's been creeping off with him before, which means this had to be happening way before he knew anything about it. So this man, Pastor Dow, stepped up, probably put on his green beret hat, you know, probably stood out there in the compound with the showing all of his accolades, you know, probably put on that militia shirt with all of his stars and stripes. And that woman looked at him as the king. That's a natural thing that these women will do. And when he start telling him what to do, make sure you pick it up. Make sure you on point. And you don't talk back to me. Can you imagine a wife sitting there listening to that? She done lost all respect for this man. He could give it up. You know, he could give it up. It had already happened, and Lord forbid, you know, either way, whatever he did, he went in on that woman, you know, showing himself to be the authoritative person, and she probably fell in love with that man. You know what I'm saying? Women, because women know the weak. You know, they can see the weak. And it starts in the mind. So if this woman hooked up with this man, and she already had this adultery going on in her mind, and her mind was ready for this man. This man could have been an average so-called lover. But in her mind, she's with a king, and it's going to amplify that much greater. And she's going to think he's the king of the throne. And then she's going to be hooked on this man. And then she's not going to want you anymore. Now, I can imagine how many other women this man did this to. Understand, women don't want what other women don't want. So if you're a man in this compound or whatever it is in this straightway gated community and no woman wants you, the other woman don't want you either. They, you know, I mean, look at the society. Those basketball players and athletes in the hotels, you think, how many women you think going up in there? And they've always called us dogs, right? Jake's better wake up, man. You gotta wake up and smell of coffee. And if you got a wife in that damn straight way, if she ain't already been tainted with that poison, as Phineas did when he had to put the poison out of Israel, when he put the javelin through the man and the woman, if it ain't already tainted, you got to get him out of there, man. Anyway, that's all I have on that. Shalom.